Hey everyone, and welcome to today's worship team conversation video. Today we're going to be talking about creating a healthy worship ministry in Romans 12. Now the book of Romans is such an important letter that Paul wrote in the first century to the church in Rome. And while it's an old book, it still has very practical implications for our lives today. Specifically, chapter 12 really helps us to get a framework of what true worship is and how we should do it as Christians in our entire lives. So I really encourage you to go through and read the entire chapter 12. It's not very long, but what I'm going to do instead of reading it for you, I'm just going to kind of show you four main sections of the chapter that show us how we can worship and what God desires from our worship. So let's take a look at the first thing, which is verses 1 and 2, and it teaches us that worship is a whole life response. William Temple says this about a whole life response to God. Worship is the submission of all of our nature to God. It is the quickening of conscience by His holiness, nourishment of mind by His truth, purifying of imagination by His beauty, opening of the heart to His love, and submission of will to His purpose. And all this gathered up in adoration is the greatest of human expressions of which we are capable. So really, that's a very eloquent way of saying that we're all to be whole life worshipers of God. And really, as we go through the rest of this conversation, understand that the point of our existence is to bring glory to God and to worship Him with our whole lives. The next thing we learn from chapter 12 comes from verses 3 to 5, and it is humility fosters unity. Each person on a worship team has a very unique job, and while we're all playing music, we're all gifted in different ways. And that's great, and we should use our gifts to help each other out, but it can get dangerous when we start to think that our gift is more important than someone else's. And really what this is we're letting pride creep in, and we're not being humble in our giftings. James 4 verse 6 says, God opposes the proud but favors the humble. That's a pretty strong verse, because what it's telling us is that God really doesn't want anything to do with your pride. He desires that we're humble before Him and also before other people. And so when we are on a worship team, we should seek to be humble servants of God and of other people, not putting ourselves or our opinions or anything above anyone else's. And really the point to being humble is that it creates unity within the team. Being a humble person will really just make you the type of person that people want to be around, that people will even ask for advice from, because they know that you're not prideful, they know that you're not just in it for yourself, and it really will just create this environment of unity where people are getting along well and you're all maximizing your gifts together for the glory of God and for the edification of the body of Christ. Okay, so the next verses that we're going to move on to is verses 6 through 8, and it teaches us that we are to use our gifts well and we're to work hard. So we've all been gifted in a certain way. The Bible tells us that God has given each one of us a unique gift, and that we're to do it, that we're to use that gift in a way that is going to build up His body. And so really what this is telling us is that we're to use our gifts well, and we need to work hard at our gifts. Because while we have these gifts, we didn't deserve them. God in His grace and His mercy chose to give us that gift. And so when we think that it's ours and we don't really need to work at cultivating it anymore, that's when we come into trouble. And again, this goes back to humility. We're to be humble in our giftings and how we view people, but also we're to work hard in our gifts and understand that in order for our gifts to grow, which God desires that our gifts will grow, we need to put in the effort and time that's required to grow those gifts. So please, in the context of how you've been gifted, never feel like you've arrived. Always be pushing yourself to get better and look for ways that you can grow your gift, because really, if you ever feel like, you know, I can never get better, eventually it's just going to start a downward spiral where you're going to get upset and discouraged about your gifting, and that's really not what God wants for you. God wants you to push forward growing your gift and helping others grow their gifts as well. And so, again, work hard and use your gifts well. Okay, and the last thing that we learn from this chapter comes from verses 9 through 21, and it is to love others. Now, this is really the rest of the chapter, the bulk of the chapter, and we could probably break it down a little bit more, but really, when you come down to it, the common thread and the common theme that runs through these verses is to love others. Looking to Jesus' words in Matthew 7, he tells us this about what it means to truly love others. Matthew 7:12 says, "So in everything, do unto others as you would have them do unto you, for this sums up the law and the prophets." People are going to make mistakes. They're going to hurt your feelings. They're going to wrong you. They're going to let you down. And really, it's up to you to respond to them in love, which is to treat others as you would have them treat you. And that doesn't always necessarily, the hard thing is, it doesn't always mean that they're going to treat you the way that you want to be treated, but it's up to you to treat them how you would want to be treated, because that's what Christ says is true love. Furthermore, in Romans 12, 17, and 18, it says, "Never pay back evil with more evil. Do things in such a way that everyone can see you are honorable. Do all that you can to live in peace with everyone." So on a worship team, do everything you can to live in peace with everyone. You know, talk with each other, have great relationships, pray with each other, play great music with each other. Really just build each other up, because when we are unified and when we have a tight-knit group, that's God-honoring, and even more so, people are going to know that and be able to see the fruits of how you're worshiping God in your relationships. And again, I encourage you, read through Romans 12. It's a great chapter. And see what you can glean from how to better worship God. And hopefully this sparks a good conversation with whoever you're going to have it with. And we hope to see you next time in the next conversation video.